Now, Payal has just obviously launched her last book, which is called Horrid High, which is obviously not the last, but the latest book.
The more horrid version comes out next year.
Okay, so Payal, you're going to take us through the Horrid High and what's it all about. And
so basically, I always wanted to write a horrid book. So that's one more confession. I just was very interested in the combination of horridness and humor that I find in some of my favorite authors. Like, again, I'm saying Roald Dahl. So I like the fact that somebody can make you squirm and somebody can make you go, ew, or say, God, that's really icky, but make you laugh at the same time.
Right.
So all the parents don't want to be parents and they're looking for a school where you can dump your child and forget about him. And all the teachers don't want to be teachers. So you... Okay, therefore inhabit a space where grown-ups don't like children very much. And then in this space, you have five children with extraordinary skills. You have a boy who's a pickpocket. You have a girl who's a hypnotist. You have a person who can pick locks. You have one more person who's a mimic. And then the hero himself is actually a very unremarkable, unheroic kind of boy. One who is easily forgotten. He's forgotten by his own parents. But, you know, sometimes being invisible or being unremarkable can also be a fantastic gift.
Right.
Of course. So,
okay.
I also want to add that the book has 15 characters.
Wow.
And it's become an inside joke that if I could have fit in more characters in the book, I would have. But there were just so many and it was a tight squeeze and a few just fell out along the way. So there are 15 characters. They all have backstories
right.
that explain why some of them are so horrid or why some of them are so special.
Right.
And a character that I really love is one of the only good grown-ups who's a jungle-saving grandmother.
Okay.
And I just thought that it was about time we brought old people back into children's books, especially into action-packed ones. You know, we don't need them to be sitting in an armchair knitting. They have to do something exciting and fantastic.
That's great. That's absolutely great. What do we expect in the next one?
Okay, so basically, Horrid High Book 2, I'm aiming for it to be even more horrid than Book 1, and there will be lots of new characters. Some of the old characters, at least the most favorite ones, will be back. Again, it will be an overcrowded book, and I'm sure that a few characters will fall out along the way. And I also have, later on in the year, another children's book probably coming out. I think that one is possibly going to be more for girls. And I'm also working on an adult book, but I won't say anything about that right now.
Okay, that sounds interesting.